Okay, so yes, I don't understand. Shika, can you try once again, please? Okay, superb. So the next thing which I wanted to say is, oh yeah, there is already one person who actually gave a small idea, Shivanshu Tiwari. I have my own website deployed in GitHub, and I'm still working on it. Dude, we are going to do something similar to that today. So it's going to be exciting. So everyone will be able to deploy their own website at the end of these 3 days. How does that sound?
Amazing.
That's
Awesome.
superb.
Yeah.
Really excited.
Great. That's interesting. So that's what we are going to do, and we'll be using Git and GitHub extensively. How many of you are not familiar with Git and GitHub? So that I can give them a small refresher session on what exactly Git and GitHub. Okay, we could see a couple of people. Right, some people raising their hands, some people adding the chat messages. Cool. There are so many people who are. Oh, okay. So all these things, after all these things, I've also got my own YouTube channel. So would you like to hit the subscribe button on this? So this is what I have got. And so let me show you what all things I have added so far. So most of the videos are related to open source, React.js, full stack web development. The main thing here is all these videos are related to JavaScript, mostly client-side JavaScript. Some of them are server-side JavaScript. React.js is one of the most in sought, like sought after job category or whatever you can call it. Okay, there is a small trivia for everyone. Can you please guess the starting cell? Again, don't Google for this. It's just for your understanding. Like, I just wanted to see your understanding of the current trends and technologies. So, what is the minimum pay package, minimum salary for React.js developer in India and in the UK? I'm from the UK. I'm in London currently. And so just give your best guesses. Okay. Even in UK, just give your best guesses in Indian rupees itself. Okay. There are some answers coming in. Keep it public. It's completely fine. I just wanted to know, and it is good to know every other's understanding as well. Hey, someone say about UK, yeah? Okay. Cool. Nice answers are coming, to be honest. Okay, so by average, I could see 6 to 12, 6 to 12 to 12.5 lakhs, 6 to 12.5 lakhs in India, and 25 to 30 lakhs per annum in UK. Okay. Seems like you're all like okayishly correct with Indian thing, and also you are very close to the UK salaries as well. India, it is around 10 to 12 lakhs at the moment, where I can see for seasoned React.js developers, and for the starting the freshers, it is 8 to 10 lakhs. Great guess. And UK, right? You are just close. Not correct. So the starting salary is 35 lakhs per annum, and for seasoned React.js developers, it can go up to 120 lakhs, which is 1.2 crores. Yes, please. Whoever wants to come to the UK and work or study, you can talk to me. And again, I have shared my social links and other things. So if you have, if you want to know more about the work culture here and other things, definitely. I have also done some videos on this too. So, by the way, here's my YouTube link again, once again, for everyone. Okay, cool. So without further delay, let's directly go into Git and GitHub. So what exactly is GitHub? I'm going to give you a small video of this so it is easier for you to learn. Instead of me teaching, it would be easy for you to learn from this awesome video that was done by Microsoft. So obviously they are better than me, right? So I'll just go with that. So YouTube. Okay, this is an awesome video. Just give me a second. I'll just try to share my sound.
Okay, what is GitHub? Well, GitHub is a platform that helps people solve...
Is everyone able to hear it?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, cool. Yeah, fine.
...problems by building software together. So, how does it work? This is Sam. Sam works on tractors all day, but not in the way you might be thinking. She builds the software that helps make tractors more efficient. And she does this on GitHub with the help of her team, Vijay, Melinda, and Mike. Now, even though they all work on the same project, Sam and her team don't all work in the same part of the world. This is Eddie. Eddie also works on tractors all day, except he actually works on the tractors all day. And this is the Harvester L700. It's the latest flagship in the company's fleet of tractors. It's full of sensors and processors that produce a ton of diagnostic data. Eddie has a great idea for how farmers might share their data and improve their harvests. So Eddie opens an issue on GitHub. Issues are discussion threads where people can report bugs, request features, or even just ask questions. Sam is the first one on her team to see Eddie's issue, and she thinks that Vijay would be the best person to start the job. And here's where we get into the nuts and bolts. Eddie isn't the only person using the Harvester L700. All over the world, other tractors are collecting moisture data, and they need to keep running smoothly even while Vijay is working on the new features. He needs a dedicated place to experiment so none of his changes end up on the farm before they're ready. So he creates a branch of the code, an alternate timeline where he can safely make changes to the software. Now he's ready to start writing the new feature. GitHub tracks Vijay's changes and saves snapshots of his progress. When he's ready to collaborate on the changes with his team, he opens a pull request on GitHub. Pull requests let you show others the changes you're proposing so they can review and discuss them. This means Vijay's teammates can help with roadblocks and even make improvements. On GitHub, everyone has a copy of the project. So if Melinda has an idea for something that will help make Vijay's work even better, she can add it to the branch herself. GitHub keeps a record of everyone's contributions and feedback in the pull request, alongside relevant messages from the team's other systems. Once the team has signed off on the changes, Vijay can incorporate the new code into the project. The new feature will be available to everyone as soon as he merges it in. Now farmers everywhere can all benefit from Eddie's great idea. But this is really only the beginning of the story. Because GitHub is the largest community of developers in the world, with millions of people sharing their projects, Eddie's idea could end up helping people in unimaginable ways. What kinds of problems are you trying to solve? Whether you're an engineer, a code enthusiast, or even a farmer trying to harvest grain, software touches every corner of our lives. GitHub is where people build that software. It's how they build software, together.
So that's a small video of what GitHub can do and how we can work with GitHub. How was the video, by the way? I'll also send the add the video URL and send it over to you. Okay, cool. Here's all the links so far. And we will be using Git and GitHub right now to work on a couple of things. So let's get started. And we are going to build a website again, right? So how many of you are familiar with React.js, or can we try to work with a small application that is going to be collaborative? Like, we have like 90 people right now here, and every one of us, we are going to work on Git and GitHub, and then we are going to make this work. Okay, how does that sound?
That's amazing.
Excellent. So we are going to do something very simple, very nice, and then very unique, maybe we can do. And we can try to show something like this, a small, let's deploy one application by today, like within half an hour. So that's the deal. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to try creating, since we have got so many people right now, 91 people, we can do in this in two ways. Okay, there is a question already. What is the difference between creating a new branch and then merging, forking a repository, and then creating a pull request? Okay, this is a good question. One thing is, for creating a new branch, you need to have write access to the repository, but most of the time you will be just a person who is an outsider in open source software. So let's say if I have my GitHub profile here, so this is my GitHub profile. Let me add that too. And if I create a repository here, I don't think you will be able to access anything from here, right? So you won't be having the right access. So to enable proposing something, a new change or something like that, you need to fork the repository, which means you make a clone of my repository on GitHub, and then you do your changes because you will be the owner of that repository, right? You create a new branch, like you create an alternate code timeline, and then create a new branch, and then start writing the code changes, and then you will be proposing the changes to my repository so that I can actually review, okay, what exactly you have changed, why you have changed, what is the intention, and then I'll add your code to mine. So which means you are requesting me to pull your changes to my repository, which is called as a pull request. Was that clear? So let's start with something like session one. What should we name here? Take a moment.
Yeah, that would be great.
Okay, so let's start with this, and we are going with the perfect GitHub ways of things. We are not going to use Google Forms, or we are not going to use. Okay, how many of you here do not have a GitHub link with you? Hey, Abir. So if you don't have a GitHub profile, it is very easy to create. All you need to do is go to github.com and then just give your email address, sign up for your GitHub. As simple as that. You don't need to give any other details. Just give your email address, sign up for GitHub. It will ask for your username and your full name. As simple as that. And that's all. So that's awesome. So look at this. This is a live graph of how many people are doing pull requests. Actually not live. It's we saw one person from India, right? So that's super cool. Yeah, so again, this is something related to agriculture. Nice. Okay, so this is exactly what I was about to tell. And we are going to create a simple website which shows all the attendees of our of our event. And since we have like more than 95 attendees, let's see how easy we can do it on GitHub rather than using a Google form or something like that. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is, so for people who have not got a GitHub account, please go ahead and create one. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a public repository. So if you're completely fine with having your name and your LinkedIn account displayed publicly, go for this. This is completely fine. And what we are going to do is, I'm going to put just a simple thing. So a quick demo to show the power of collaboration. So let's say if I just need only, I just have like only 10 minutes and I want to create a list of our list of people, like, you know, something like this. Okay. So what I can do is, so I just create a public repository here. So if I just create repository, so this will be viewable by everyone. So I'm just going to give this link to everyone. Yeah, GitHub or GitHub Desktop. GitHub Desktop is the GitHub client. I always use either GitHub Web or the command line, which is easier. And you can also use the built-in tools in Visual Studio Code and other things. Before that, I'll also show you my personal development environment, how this, how it looks and stuff like that. So GitHub repository. Let's start with something simple, okay? We are going to create something in a very simple way. What exactly are we creating here? So we are just creating a text file, okay? I'm just going to say attendees.txt. JSON is better, but txt will be more easier to work with. Okay, that is the reason I'm just going to create a text file. And we are going to programmatically get all the data from this text file and then display it on our front-end web application with our faces and with our links to all these things. Okay, so that's exactly what I'm going to do. So the first line what I'm writing is, so everyone, what you do is, I'm going to show how to do it using another account and stuff like that. So I'm starting with my name in the normal way, how I would be happy to get it in the certificates and stuff like that. So Praveen Kumar, that is my name. And then with a comma, without any spaces, I'm putting my LinkedIn profile. I hope everyone has a LinkedIn profile. So let's create one. And if you don't, please go ahead and create one, because it is going to help you in a lot better way. And then I give another comma. These are like comma separated values, okay? And I'm giving my username, GitHub username, okay? So these are the three basic things that I'm using. And then in a single line, okay? So I'm just created a list of attendees. Now I just committed a new file here. So this is, since I have the complete control on this repository, I have everything is there. Like I can just create a file just like that. But for people who do not have, okay, let's start with creating a pull request from another repository. Okay, so if I go to this particular repository from another person's profile, so I need to go sign in first to do any kind of changes. For example, if I need to do any changes, I need to be signed in, or I need to create a new account. So let's sign in as another person. Just give me a second. I'll just try to find another username and then sign in with that. Okay, so now I have signed in as some person. So what we need to do is, once you go to this page, right? So everyone who have signed into your GitHub accounts, just go to this page and then click on this fork this project and edit the file. Okay, so the moment you click on this, you will be able to see this particular page. And here at the last line, add your name. I guess we can already see there are two pull requests coming in. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to give a fictional name, like hello world. And then there will be no spaces, by the way. So I'm just going to give another link, https://linkedin.com/in/hello world. And then the next thing is going to be the GitHub username. In my case, it is Praveen Science, or in this case, it is Hello World. And I'm just proposing the changes as added my details, something like this. And then click on propose changes. What happens is, it is going to create a small commit message. And this is going to say like all these things, like I'm comparing the patch one with the base branch. Okay, yes, I'm okay with this. Only this line has been added. Just click on the create pull request. And it says added my details as a part of this tech command. I'm a part of tech a month. So this will actually convince the owner to, okay, you are the right person who is getting added. And then clicking on pull request will get to this page where I'll be waiting for, I'll be able to review it and then accept it. Now, going back to the pull request, thanks for bringing in all the pull requests, all these things, you will be getting a lot of, you know, like, so there is a gamification as well. So if you create a pull request, you get your streak here. There is this green box. So this is very, I mean, it's like a game, right? So this is the day where I have done a lot of contributions here, here, and here, etc. So companies will also see about this, how active you are on LinkedIn, and sorry, how active you are on coding sites like GitHub, Stack Overflow, etc. So these helps. So let's see, let's refresh pull requests for four PRs. So I'll go with the first awesome PR by Abir Pal, I guess, right? There you go. So let's have a quick look. See, already he has made a lot of changes now. So if I see here, yeah, but this is not quite right because he has to add his GitHub username as well. So I'm just going to either I can say request changes and reject it, or I'll just do an approval. But I would like to edit this file. So this can be done from added Abir's name or something like that, right? So Abir's GitHub ID. And moreover, a lot of companies, they will be making sure that the format that you are giving is extremely correct. Like it's with the right stuff and etc. So please just make sure of that. So looks good to me, and I can give a plus one and then I'll submit the review. So the moment I do this, I can actually merge a pull request using a squash merge. I will generally do a squash merge because, okay, about squash mergers and other things, it's a big story there. So look at Abir doing all the crazy things. Yeah, so Abir's details. And boom. So this is what is going to happen in my end. And once I do this, there are more pull requests coming in. So let's go to the next one. Let's see if this is correct. Okay, there is conflict. Damn. Okay, so what is conflict? What is a conflict resolution? So what we are going to do is we have got the same kind of a thing, like let's try to resolve the conflicts. What we are going to do is we have to take both the details from here. So we are just going to take this and I'll just say mark as resolved. I understand. Update the main branch. And then if you see this, we have this person's name and we can approve it. Looks good on the first attempt. Congrats, Harikate. And I guess we will be getting a lot of merge conflicts right now, I believe. So I'll just do a squash and merge. Now the problem here is it will be like, I believe it's going to be easy this way rather than using, in case if there are like multiple people looking at it, and if I have a lot of people here, so that would be easier as well. So let's try the next one. Let's see if this is fine. There is a space here. So let's edit this. So this is the way we will generally do it using, I guess this is also has conflict. Yeah, right, has conflicts. So every single thing will have conflicts now. I guess I took a wrong method right now and we can directly go ahead and update it. So squash and merge. So this is one way of getting some information with something like this. Okay, so let's go ahead and quickly finish all these things. And that's hello world. That's the thing which I did. So I'm just gonna say rejected. This is not the right thing. So what I can do is, I realize you're not a part of this. And then I can just close with comment, boom, bye. And this is a way people can reject it as well. So these are different things that happens here. So now if we go here, we have Shikas, but again, there is a space, there is no HTTPS. So these are a couple of things that we can work on. So we'll just finish off, like merge all these three pull requests alone and then try to work this one. So this is Shika 2961. So it should be like this. And this should have a HTTPS in front and no spaces. So these are a couple of things. Fixed syntax. This might sound looking, why do we do a lot of things, but going forward, this is actually easier than what we generally do. So in case if we use something like a form or something, but yes, even forms are working in this case, but yes, I did not expect this will be showing something crazy. Maybe it is because that it is a TXT file that is showing that way, but yes. So let's squash and merge. There is also the new version of GitHub, which has Shubham was asking about this question. How can we contribute to someone else's repository, like saving issues to this repo? This is how you would be contributing to a random person's repository. So this is the right way to do it as well. So I'm just going to fast forward these things. So this one, this one, this one. So let's go to the files change, files change, files changed, and has a problem. This also has a problem. This is the only thing that looks fine. So let's directly go here. Let's try to resolve the conflicts. Remove this, remove this, remove this, and I guess we can resolve it. Commit, update the main. Squash it. And merged. So here, if you see, this should have. Yes, most of the time they need to fetch upstream and then update their side of things. And it's going to be really a bigger thing that, I mean, like, if I tell all these upstream and other things, it is going to confuse everyone. So that's, I'm not going to talk about that right away, but let's go ahead and just stop with these two things. So squash and merge. And this doesn't have any, any issues right now. So, okay, this doesn't seem correct to me. Did I mess up something? No, I did not. Why does this show this way? So it just shows only one line change. Interesting. So if I try merging this, I don't want to see only three lines here. Cool. We have got everything here. So which is cool, which is actually GitHub is very, it is smart enough to understand that we have got like, oh, okay. Everyone is actually updating everything. That's great. This is the right way to do it as well. Thanks. So I'm going to resolve the conflicts. Get rid of these things. Oh. This person tried to resolve the conflicts, but looks like their detail is actually removed. Okay, so let's go back to their pull request again. and then try to see what exactly happened and the files changed. Oh, it's in the second line. Yeah, it is there. So we can just mark as resolved, commit the merge, and let's crash and merge. Added. Prachi. Okay, cool. So now if we see here, inside our, we have no pull request, which is cool. Now, if we see this attendees.txt, we can find all these things in the right way possible. I hope they are right. Hopefully, yeah, they are hopefully right. So for now, we have got like 8 people who have added to this one. Now, the first thing which we want to see is like make this into a Jamstack. How many of you know what a Jamstack is? J-A-M stack. That's exactly what we are going to do today. JavaScript, APIs, and markup. So this is one of the most commonly used things that are happening this during this time. So we'll be using a Jamstack and we will be working on this. So right now we have got our API done. It's kind of like an API. So how are we going to access this? We can go to the settings. There is an option called pages. And we can enable that. And then we will save it. So the moment we do this, your site is ready to be published at this part. Great. And I'm going to create a quick readme here with all these links that we actually wrote right now. Let's start with, okay, let me first add links to these things. And this is take a month session one. We'll say full stack session one. Okay. And this is a part of Praveen's session on full stack development covering APIs and Jamstack. Okay. Something like this, which I have written. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy this whole thing and I recommend Typora. This looks really nice. And let's put this quick demo also works, helps. Added a readme. And I always love to use this format. Don't do this, but many people will frown this kind of a readme. So now once we do this way, if I refresh the page, we need to look at the GitHub pages thing. So it has been updated here 1 minute ago. I guess someone has created another one, Abhinav. Okay, so let's see those changed files. It looks fine to me. Cool. So let's give a plus one for this review. And approve the changes. The moment I approve the changes, it will ask me to squash and merge. And added Abhinav, and I'm just merging it. The moment I merge it, you can see something like a GitHub action should just kick in. You can see there is an orange color dot here. So this will turn into a green color checkbox. Once it turns into a check mark, what you can do is, okay, by the way, so far, any questions? Please, there are 83 people right now. Any questions at all? Have you got any questions? I can share all the links once again. Any questions at all? Okay, so once we have got this updated, so if we go back to our pages, we will be able to see this URL. Okay, so the moment I open this one, it was going to show this one. And oh, that's not right. So if we go back to the code and click on this readme. Oh yeah. This is how it shows, right? Okay, that's fine. And we just need to open this attendees.txt file. So / attendees.txt. The main thing that we need to look at is, we know we can see these things, right? But in the network tab, if we see here, there is something called as access control allow origin. So if this is star, you can actually open this, you can use this inside a part of an AJAX call. So what is an AJAX call? It is called asynchronous JavaScript and XML. So we are going to create a quick simple React application. So I'm using something called as VS Code for creating React applications, but it's up to you to use the same thing. So this is how my VS Code configuration looks like. So it is going to help me with a lot of like being lazy and stuff like that. So we have got like so many, I've got like these 8 or 9 extensions that are installed, which help me in doing being lazy. So if I set it to JavaScript React, and if I want a class component, boom, there is a class component here as quick as it. So I can just make app, and then I can have here dot app inside this. I want to have, let's say we have a heading which says take a month attendees. And along with that, we can have a paragraph which says, here's all the attendees for take a month event. And then I'm just going to put something else as well. And we can give a UL dot attendees. And then boom, I've got my complete, HTML done for me. So this is how exciting is this? Like you can just write a couple of lines of code. And if you don't have all these set up, you can directly go to react.new. Bam, you get all these set up in the web as well. So this is easy to use that. So let's go back. React. Code sandbox react.new, and I'll just put this one. Oh, I need to also add this thing as well. Boom. So if I refresh this page, we should be able to see these things. Cool. This works. Now, coming to the real part, here is where we will be working on creating this awesome, details and other things. So we will be, we will be using a AJAX call for this, right? It is called as a fetch API. It is a built-in API, but before that, we will see how React works. React works with states and props. So this is a state object, and we can have attendees as an array. And now here, we can also see what exactly is going on inside the attendees array. Okay, so I'm just going to use a pre tag with json.stringify and get that this.state, and this is the spacing which I wanted to use. So since it doesn't look all good, okay, this should be this.state, sorry. So we have got this, and we can make dot app pre, let it has border 1px solid hash ccc border radius 5px. Let's make it text align left. And okay. So this will give you what is exactly there in the state. So what we are going to do is we need to have the details loaded onto this. Okay. So right now, what do we have? Where is the details available from this, right? So if I try to do a component dead mount or something like that, this is something like once your document is ready, once your application has mounted and it is ready, then do something. So I'm asking it to fetch a particular website. And then what happens is this will be a response stream. I don't want the response stream as such. So I want it to be converted into text. Sorry, this is text. And then the text can be used for anything. So for example, if I do this dot set state, So raw text is text. And then if I save it, we can see that the whole, the whole text is here right now. So we know that this is working right now. So we have got all these things. So what we are going to do now is, I don't want this raw text right now, but instead I want to split the text into, first I want to split it into all these. Okay, before that, let's keep doing the raw text as well. So text equal to text dot split of new lines. So if I do this, immediately you can see that raw text becomes an array of new lines. Okay, but we can also see that there is an empty array as well. We need to avoid that. So what we can do is, we can do a small filter boolean. So this will remove this particular empty text. The next thing that we are going to do is, each of these are containing three different variables or three different information. So we can map it. So map it, this is going to be a person. Each person can be split to person.split on comma. Boom. So you can see that all these three things, like everything is being split into these three parts, but this could be done in a better way, right? So what we can do is, let's make it in a better thing. So the first one is going to be the name. So const, the first element is name, second element is LinkedIn, third element is GitHub. Okay, so, and what we are going to send over is these three things: return an object with name, LinkedIn, and GitHub. Boom. Is everything correct here so far? Does it look okay? So what we did is, we fetched a text file from a GitHub repository that we all contribute to, and then we parse it in such a way that we are able to get the right answers or something like that. And then the next thing that we are going to do is, Vaibhav here?
Yeah, yes, sir.
Okay. So he's the one who called me, so I just wanted to make sure if he is here. Okay, cool. So this is not just the raw text, this is what we actually want. So what we can do is, we can set the attendees as this one. So attendees is the text. So instead of text, we can actually change it to attendees here. So F2, attendees, enter, and we can remove this one as well. So now we have got all our attendees, which are from the GitHub repository. Okay, so now what we are going to do is, we are going to create a mapping again for this dot state dot attendees, and we are mapping it to each person here. And let's create a list item. Okay, now for this, for React to work, we already know there are several attendees right now here like this, right? So we can say, whoever is sending the pull request or adding this data, they are the correct attendee. So something like that, but just kidding. I'm not in a position to add all pull requests at the like immediately. Okay, so the first thing that we need to do is, we need to add a key here. So the key is going to be coming from the maps list. So I'll just put a key here, and then we have got, we can use something like a strong tag. So we can have three paragraphs. All right. So what I'm going to do here is p*3 and then strong plus span, something like this. So this has the strong, span, everything, or instead, A. So what we can do is, all these three A's would be like this, because we are going to use the dynamic thing for this. And this one can be inside a strong. So we'll use this. inside a strong because that's your name. Okay, cool. So if I add this here, it is gonna shout at us because obviously it has to be linked. So, oh well, we don't need the link here at least. So let's start with the links to be correct. So one thing will be LinkedIn. So we can do connect with me on LinkedIn and then check out my projects on GitHub. Okay, so far we have got all these things, but we haven't got the name. So a.name, boom. So at the moment, we have got all our names and other things added here. So we can see that everything is working fine. So we don't need to debug this anymore. So we'll get rid of this one and the styles. So if we try to change these things, first thing is .app attendees. You don't need a margin. Okay, so these things can actually be given for a greater thing. So font family, I'm just going to use Open Sans and font size is okay. All these things are okay. So we can quickly change a couple of things and then show this is how we can do things. And margin zero, padding zero, list style none. So you can see that everything is getting messed up. That's completely fine. So we will also do something else as well. So we can add an external resource. Let's say we'll use an Open Sans font. And okay, this looks better. Font weight normal. Yes. So app has got this text align center. How many of you would like a dark header? How many of you would like a how many of you would like a light header? So tell me, how many dark, how many light? So this, we have used the H1 here. So what we will do is
more boards are in dark.
More dark, right? Great. Okay, we'll go with the dark one. So let's start with the background color being 000 and color being FFF and font weight being 300. And okay, so this will not work in this case. So let's go back, external resources, get rid of this Open Sans. And instead, what I'm going to do is fonts.google.com and then Open Sans, and we'll just have 300, 400, and 600. Let's use these things in a different way. So let's copy this one and let's go back to our public HTML. And then here we'll add the fonts and close it. Boom. So that works. So now we have done this. We can have font size as 1.2 em and padding 10 pixels. That looks good. Margin bottom 15 pixels. Boom. So here's the attendees information. And attendees, we can have margin 15.0. And this is going to be interesting right now. So what I'm going to do now is going to change the body with a background color of FIFIFI. Or yeah, that's fine. And for each of these list items, what I want is I want to give a background color of FFF. Great. Okay, that doesn't show anything nice. So let's do a display flex. That's kind of like it kind of screwed up everything, right? Okay, cool. And we can do one more thing. We will also do flex wrap. So we can't see anything at the moment here. So at least it is kind of like a bit of a responsive thing. So we can do border 1px solid hash CCC. And let's give margin 10 pixels. We can give border radius 5px. than padding 5x. Okay, so if we see it in the normal view, you will be able to see it as looking really good. And margin, we can just leave it to 5 pixels so that it shows it in a better way. Then we need the strong to have font weight 600. Boom. And finally, this is my GitHub. This is definitely Shika's GitHub. Okay, now here is where the problem is. So we need to give ahref https://github.com/this. So if you open this one, it's going to open miner. Yes, it's opening perfectly. The only thing that we need to do is make sure all these links open in a new window. So, oh, this one and this one should have a target, which is blank. And not just that, we have to also give rel no referrer, because this is for a search engine optimization or something like that. This is something very important that we need to do. So boom, that's it. So we have got all of our stuff here, but still something is missing. So how do you get the avatar of GitHub user? Get avatar of GitHub. So avatars.github.com/username. That's it. As simple as that. And if you do something like /Praveen Science, it's just going to show me my avatar, which is cool, right? So at this point, what I will do is I'll put an image SRC. Again, it's going to be a dynamic image. So I'll just put /a.github. And I guess it should be avatars.github user content, right? Okay, cool. It has an alt. We need to give what exactly this thing means. So it's name, and then let's close it. Boom. So we have got everything working here. Now, the only thing that we need to do is make the image look good. So img width 100, height 100. Okay, that looks good. Maybe we can do it something better. So border radius 100%. Boom. So we got something which looks better, and we can also do a small glow as well. Box shadow. See, no inset. Horizontal offset is 0. Vertical offset is 0. Blur is 3px. And there you go. So yeah. So we can give a background color as well as 000. So for those people who have not got a picture or something like that, okay, that works actually. That's fine. So we can just get rid of this background color really. Bam. We got this, and it also looks like it is kind of responsive too. So the only problem is it is not actually taking up the correct responsiveness. So flex grow 1. Bam. Done. A responsive website with our profiles, portfolios, everything. Anyone would like to give another pull request? Okay, so here is the source code for this one. And here is the complete demo, working demo, and working live demo, to be honest. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy this all things, put it inside this README, and added demo links. Now, the fun part is I'll go to these pull requests. We'll add Kalyanjit's and others requests as well. This looks fine. So I'm just going to give approval and submit the review. It has a conflict. Okay, cool. Let's resolve the conflicts. Boom, boom, boom. Remove and merge the conflict. Commit the merge. Add this. Okay, so before that, I wanted to show you, this is what it was showing, right? So I'll just open this in this page so that you can actually see what is happening here. Okay, so we have got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 9 folks here. Okay, and if I go back to the pull request, okay, I haven't merged it, is it? Great. Added Kalyanjit. Then let's go back to pull requests. This is Manish. Resolve the conflicts. This looks fine to me. So let's commit it. Is it looking fine? Yes, it looks fine. Merge, yeah, that's fine. And let's squash and merge. Added Manish Kumar. And let's merge. Now the last one by Darshan. So resolve the conflicts again, as usual. Last resolution of conflicts. This doesn't have the GitHub account, so let's add it. Let's make sure everyone has their GitHub accounts. Yes, everything is fine. So let's mark as resolved. Let's commit the merge and squash and merge, added. So next time when you're doing it, make sure you give the right pull request or right subject. Okay, so we have added Darshan's one as well. So once we go here, have I touched any changes? Have I made any changes in the code? Can you please say yes or no? Did I make any changes in the code so far? No, that's correct. Okay, haven't changed anything in the code. All the thing that has been changed is the GitHub repository, and it is done by you, not me. Okay, I just merged it. If I give the power to, let's say, Sparsh or Pankaj or Vaibhav or Shruti, definitely they can also merge it. And I'm not even touching the code. I'm not even touching the repository. We saw this page, right? If I just open this page once again in a new page and hit the refresh a couple of times, maybe. Okay, this is not working. So let's refresh this page. So it says tick. So if we try to empty the hard cache and blah, 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 boom, there you go. So we got all these details. This is something like a collaborative work environment. So again, once again, I would like to send all these links. Please, please, please go ahead and hit on the subscribe button. Vikrant, we just saw the whole process of pull request. Did you not see that, or did you miss it by any chance? Okay, let me know. So what we did is we went to this page from this particular thing. So I don't have an access to this one. I click on attendees. I go to this, edit, make some changes, propose changes. That's how I make a pull request. All right. And I believe there is another pull request saying Aryans add. So squash and merge, or like mix, let's resolve the conflicts. Ooh. Okay. So Vikrant, you can try the pull request as well before this whole thing is working, like before it is closed or something like that. So let's mark it as resolved. And I hope everything is working fine. Everyone's thing is, okay, let's look at the files changed. And seems like there are like so many changes here. So fine, there is a beer here. I hope the whole file has only one instance of a beer pal or something like that. There is some conflict. Okay, so there is Sparsh already here, Sparsh is here. Harikate is also there. Birpal is there, Aryan Sharma, Aryan. Okay, Aryan is the new one, I guess. Okay, fine. What I'm going to do is I can't look into this one. So quickly go to remove duplicate lines, text mechanic, and just go here. Let's see how many things are getting removed. Remove duplicate lines. There are three duplicates as expected. So let's edit the file. Let's remove dupes. And now this particular code is ready to be merged. Only one line should be added. Let's refresh the page. Yeah, there is only one line because these things went to here and Abhinav is also here. That's fine. Okay. So don't worry. I believe there is a recording for everyone. So that will be available. So added Aryan and boom. So now we have got this. And if we go back, go to the React app. Again, if you open this in a new tab, I believe we should be getting the latest one. So if I hard refresh it, again, I guess we need to go through the same empty cache and hard reload. So boom, please get to the next one. Yes, there we go. So we got a new person now, Sparsh Mehta, or is it, who's this? Aryan Sharma, this person. Okay, so I hope you all enjoyed what we saw right now. It is one of the easiest ways of using a Jamstack. And yes, so okay, over to you, host. And thanks a lot for giving me this opportunity.
Thank you, sir, for this insightful session. Vaibhav, I would like to tell you to me.
Sir, thanks for this session. It was indeed a great session, I believe. And we had great amount of participation too. And they all have learned a lot from you. And sir, definitely you're doing a great for the student community, whether it's about development regarding knowledge and all. So a big thanks to you. Thanks to all the participants for joining today's session. Tomorrow and day after tomorrow also, we are going to have Praveen sir with us.
But it will be a short session, okay?
Yeah.
And one more thing which I wanted to ask is, it's a kind request from my side. Go ahead, hit the subscribe button on my YouTube channel. A lot more videos are coming up like this, and this will actually motivate me to do a lot. So that's the only reason.
Exactly, guys. If you want to join such channel, definitely go and press the subscribe channel. And if you miss any part of the session for today, we'll be providing you with the recording links. So don't worry for that. You can also watch it on our YouTube channel. So that's all for the today's session. Pankaj, can you please share the feedback form?
Yes.
And Vaibhav?
Yes, sir.
Did you check out what I sent you yesterday?
Yes, sir. Definitely.
Okay, shall we use that?
Yeah, you can.
I guess we will be showing a demo of that on the third day then. Excellent.
Okay, that's good that we'll be having it on the third day. Okay.
Excellent, excellent.
And I would also like to thank our branch counsel, Sugandha ma'am, for such a great session, for helping us to organize such a great session. Also, thanks to whole team for working so hard in order to manage this session. Great thanks to each and every participant joining us, Tech Volunteer, Tech Ambassador, each and everyone. Thanks a lot, everyone.
I would like to request volunteering team to please share the feedback form.
Yeah, so feedback form is in the chat section. Guys, do fill the feedback form in order to get the certification from our side. And don't forget to join tomorrow's and day after tomorrow's session. It will be really a great session as today we had with Praveen sir.
We'll be waiting. See you all then. I have to rush to my office in 10 minutes. So.
Okay, great, sir. Thank you. Thanks a lot.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you, sir.
Trent has sent the pull request. Sure, man. I'll update it. See ya.
Bye, sir. Bye-bye. Okay, so participants, we'll be waiting for 2 more minutes. Do fill the feedback form as soon as possible. Thank you to the whole team. Thank you to the, if I believe that we are also having an IEEE chair with us. So thanks a lot, sir, also for providing us this golden opportunity. And we are going to have this 1 month continued technical learning session. We'll be bringing much more good sessions for you. Currently, we are going ahead with the web track. And tomorrow and day after tomorrow, as I mentioned, that we are having web tracks too with Praveen Sir. So I believe that all of you are going to join. And Praveen sir has also shared some link on chat section. You can click them and view them. It will be really helpful for you all. Thanks to the whole Techamon team for working so hard in order to organize. Thanks to Komal. Thanks to Pankaj for hosting today's event. Thanks a lot to both of you.
You're most welcome, Vaibhav sir.
Okay, guys, so we'll be ending the session. Once again, thanks to everyone.